So we'd like to welcome you all and thank you all for coming again for this unconventional morning performance of public reading of The Vegan of Venice by Ella Stanley Jr. and me, Holly Barber. A couple of quick notes that we found would have been helpful to give last time we did the performance. This is a reading, which means that as throughout the play process, we were getting updated pages, we were adjusting lines as needed. The students had 1 week to prepare this, and it was not this past week. It's been a week off for them as they've been preparing for the performance last night. So they received the sides Sunday night, 2 Sundays ago. They had auditions on Monday during class, and Tuesday through Friday we rehearsed during class time. And on Saturday we had a morning rehearsal before performing at the Ethical Society Saturday afternoon. And the other thing you need to know is that there are 12 songs in the musical. You'll hear 7 of them today. In music form. The others will be spoken as lyrics. So if it feels like there are some dry sections of the musical, it's probably a part where the song either hasn't been written yet or we didn't have time to prepare it with the time that we had. Alice and my mantra as we were working on this was, you get the idea. The idea with a reading is to get your work out there, get it heard, get it workshopped by more, you know, minds than just the two of you working on it. So you're not in an echo chamber anymore. So we think you will get the idea, and we hope you really enjoy it. Thank you so much for being here.
All right, Vegan of Venice, a new one-act musical by Alice Stanley Jr., music by Holly Barber. I'm going to introduce our actors. Brittany Barthelmess will be reading the role of Jessica. Molly Lovelace will be playing the role of Shia LaBeouf. Liam Frager will be reading the role of Duke. Jake Sablon will be playing the role of Tony. Juliet Beck will be playing the role of Portia. Noah Fredrickson will be playing the role of Bax. And Holly Barber will be playing the role of Doc New Year. Lights up. We see a classroom set up like a makeshift courtroom. School bell rings.
Baxter. I am student body President Duke in my courtroom.
Classroom.
Thank you for calling the meeting, President Duke.
Well, if it isn't, you shut up.
Bless you.
Councilman, behave yourself in my courtroom.
Classroom.
Would you read today's opening statement, Bailiff Lincoln?
Are you talking to me?
Who else would I be talking to?
The bailiff.
That's you, Link. You're the freshman representative.
This student council meeting in regard to club funds at Venice High School will come to order. Today's meeting has been called at the request of Shiloh Locke. Is Ms. Shiloh Locke present?
Present.
And the defendant, Tony Chop?
If I'm not mistaken, today's meeting of Shiloh Locke versus Tony Chop is in regards to a contract, an unorthodox one at that.
Excuse me, it's 20 past 3.
Here we go. Yeah, Shiloh, we started late. We can't all be perfect like you.
I was only wondering, where is our faculty sponsor? Doesn't it seem like she should be here by now? Talk New Year's sponsors like 12 clubs, but she always shows up eventually.
She'll be here. She usually leaves a note. Here it is. At emergency budget cut meeting for the English department, then checking in on many libertarians of America. See you soon. We'll get started.
But the guidebook says...
Chill. She's on her way. We can't make any final decisions without her anyway.
Tony, I understand you are a member of the Venice High Eco Club. Today you will be represented by Eco Club President and Vice President, Council People Baxter and Portia.
That's us, Eco Club represent.
Baxter and DC!
And student body member Locke, has your representation arrived yet?
Yes.
And he is, excuse me, he or she, that's the last thing we need for the gender equality which should come after us. So, your representation, Ms. Locke?
Nice S, like the letter?
What does the transcript say, Link?
Is that my job?
The freshman rep always takes down transcription of our meetings.
I'm not very good at taking notes.
Link, work with me here.
I know, but my doctor calls junior carpal tunnel. I can't even go bowling. But I'll try.
No need to have the disability center on our case.
I have voice recording on my phone, Your Highness.
Great idea. Voice recording will ensure other potentially offensive comments don't accidentally slip. Councilman.
I said nice S. Even the club title?
Shiloh's club is called the Vegans of Venice, but she is the only member. Bax is making a mean joke, which I apologize for, that it should really be called the Vegan of Venice.
Ah. Yes, have you considered changing your name?
The low membership is new. Hopefully temporary.
Regardless, you are representing yourself.
Yes, I guess so.
Very well, let's begin. When Mr. Chop...
Let the record show His Majesty is gesturing to a desk. I will presume that is what he considers the stand.
One moment, Mr. Chop. The other thing.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help you. So help you understanding Shakespeare for the freshman reader.
Yeah. Tony, we're here today to contest the deal you made with the Shiloh Law, correct?
Yeah.
A deal you made official by contract, correct?
Yeah.
Were you coerced at all to sign this contract?
No.
Were you under any type of influence?
Slugs not try to escape.
So you signed this contract completely willing of your own accord?
I thought you wanted me to do that.
I do. I'm just making it clear to everyone present.
Okay.
So, Tony, you freely signed a contract with Miss Locke last Wednesday, and yet you're coming to student council asking it to be annulled?
Man, it doesn't sound so good.
Will you please sum up why you're asking for the annulment?
Why I don't think I should do what the contract says?
If you could.
Because it's crazy. Mr. Chop, watch your language.
Could you elaborate for us?
Crazy. Cray-cray. Bonkers. Next stop on the same stage.
Mr. Chop!
Now, Tony, I know you did not mean to offend, but this kind of offensiveness must end. Crazy is a medical term, not a jibe, okay? Just think of what Psychology Club would say. Correct, correct, correct. You've got to know. You step on toes, you've got to be correct. That's kind of lame. The dictionary says lame is someone who can't walk. So again, I must plead, you stop the slanderous talk. Your words, they hurt, they bite, they cut, the pain is inescapable. It's basically a slur for the handicapable. Correct, correct, correct. And in this room, it's extra true. We've got to be correct.
You can be really extra.
Extra what? Everyone is welcome here, LGBTQ&A. You will get kicked out of court if you call someone gay. Wait, what did I just say? I don't care what your sex is, I don't want to talk about it. I never mentioned your race, don't you ever doubt it. Unspecific pronouns, gender's a social construct. Leave much to say, but better than rude conduct. The Americans, not Indians, underprivileged, not lower class. Our sports team has to be PC. The Venice High Plains of grass. Don't give me that sass. Cursory, not history. High challenge, not short. No cheerleaders, no jocks, just people who like the sport. Not losers, social specialists, not geeks, just outliers. I've never met a wimp before, only natural criers. Don't call anyone smart cookies, some of us are gluten-free. Don't offend Europeans with, it's all Greek to me. Kill two birds with one stone can sound like an attack. And never in this courtroom can you call a kettle black. Correct, correct, correct. That's how it goes, you step on toes. But try to be correct.
Oh, I see.
A picture is not worth a thousand words in your mind. In everything you say, there's something offensive to find. So try to be correct.
Tony, why don't you tell the court the circumstances of your conversation with Miss Locke that led to the creation of the contract and your subsequent signing of it? In your own words.
Starting from what?
The beginning.
Most of you know me as Tony, cool leader around Venice High, winner of last year's Earth Day Planet Tree, but others call me, and I'm not trying to be funny, Mr. Cash Money. By the end of this, you'll see what I earned. You miss a shot of lock, you're gonna get burned. Yeah, that's right, I'm treasurer of Eco Club. I keep the ledger. I sign the checks. Most importantly, I get the funds for our annual Eco Carnival. This year was gonna be off a biodegradable paper chain, a dump tank filled with water from the rain. How could I know the fun would be upturned?
You mess with child lock, you're gonna get burned!
But math's never been my strong suit. I'm more about looking cute. I messed up the budget, I couldn't budget. We didn't have a strill up front, but I didn't stunt. Every year we make a huge profit, and this wasn't gonna stop it. I knew what wasn't blown, all I needed was a loan. I hadn't known yet, I hadn't learned.
You mess with child lock, you're gonna get burned!
I asked all the other clubs, but the year is almost up. Everyone's broke, except one club, the Vegan Club. Ask them, everyone says. So I met with their prez. I was clueless. I was so unconcerned.
You met the child lock? You're gonna get burned!
So I walked right up to her and told her the sish, how we were good for the money. She'd get it back, no problem. I expected an easy go. She said no. And then my stomach churned.
You met the child lock? You're gonna get burned!
I can't understand it. We both want what's best for the environment, and she flat out refused to help.
If you're gonna tell the story, you should finish it.
Like how you call me a hypocrite for the school's greenest fixture.
But you don't see the big picture.
Did you know shower weeks conserve water?
Did you know it takes 600 gallons for one hamburger to be slaughtered?
You got glass recycling to cut down on waste.
Why not in factories in the first place?
I always walk or bike. I never get a ride.
Beef creates more greenhouse gases than transit worldwide.
Your Honor, these are ruthless attacks.
There's some pretty good facts.
Looks like the tables have turned. You messed with Shiloh Locke and she got burned.
Order, order. So what happened next? How does this contract come into play? Right as I was about to walk away, she said she'd give me a loan for a whole half a K. Under one condition, I'd have to pay her by 9 a.m. Monday morning or become a vegan that day.
So can this court be adjourned? You mess with Shiloh Locke, you're gonna get burned.
The prosecution's first piece of evidence.
Let the record show, Ms. Locke has provided the court with a contract dated last Wednesday.
See? There it made sense, you let the record show. That would be a good name for a game show about music, huh? Let the record show, get it? Because show and record?
And I quote, I, Tony Chop, being of sound mind and body, on behalf of Eco Club, do swear to uphold the terms of this contract, drafted in lunch period A, on this day, 2 Wednesdays before graduation. I, Tony Chop, do promise to return $500 to Shiloh Locke on behalf of the Vegans of Venice, no later than 9 a.m. next Monday. If I fail to do so, I will become a vegan. But Tony, is this your signature?
It is, Your Honor.
Your Honor is also acceptable.
Yes, there was a contract, but as Tony previously stated, it seemed crazy. Excuse me. Ridiculous. Almost a joke.
Objection. A contract is a contract.
Yes, Ms. Locke, I know. Councilman Baxter, could you please stick to the facts?
She thinks she's so smart. Stick to the facts, like the fact that Shiloh Locke got 3 Pizza of Fridays canceled on account of, quote, not every student cares to participate, end quote.
That was you.
She plays it cool and sweet.
And she said we weren't going to bring that up.
But I know who she really is. Our second piece of evidence. It's time to turn up the heat.
Let the record show, evidence B is an email from one Shiloh Locke to Principal Hershey regarding free Pizza Fridays. And I quote, using taxpayer funds to buy pies of bovine lactate is not only disgusting, it is morally absurd.
Bovine lactate.
Cheese. A cow's milk. Milk for all animals is a lactate meant for feeding a species young. Cheese is breast milk from a cow.
Has this memo been falsified?
The gas is kicking.
That was a private email between myself and Principal Hershey. I don't know how the defense has it.
Dial set to 10.
You're the reason we don't have free Pizza Fridays anymore.
How is that pertinent?
She's really sweating now. Duke, I wanted to show you the type of person we're working with here.
I only expressed my opinion, which we
hearing from her mouth, ladies and gentlemen, we all have the right to express ourselves. And if Tony expresses himself by eating a box of chicken head...
Self-expression is much different than acting in accordance with a contract.
I ate a slice of Hawaiian thin crust extra sauce pizza every Friday for the past 3.5 years. And 1 month before graduation, poof, divine decadence has slapped out of my hungry fist.
Yes, I imagine it's a similar feeling for mother cows when their cows are kidnapped to become meal.
Your presidency.
So, Tony, you agreed to become vegan if you didn't get the loan back to Shiloh by Monday at 9. What happened?
If I may, Evidence C. A statement of our profits and funds as of Monday morning. Our carnival was a huge success. We were able to keep $500 for next year's budget, which is our goal, set aside Ms. Locke's $500 for imminent return, and we still have $350 to donate to Amazon River Wildlife. Yes.
I'm sorry, but don't you think it's funny you're gathering money to save animals across the world when you could save the ones right here by simply not eating them?
Amazon dolphins are not raised for the purpose of being eaten.
They're also endangered.
We've been over this, Shiloh, in the junior locker bay last year when I invited you to our spring barbecue.
You had no intention of becoming my friend. You invited me to a barbecue.
We were gonna serve black bean burgers.
You didn't say that.
You didn't give me a chance. If you recall, you were too busy crumpling up the flyer I handed you and chucking it out in the face.
It was a flyer with a steak on it. Even if you were to have a vegan option, do you really think that's the best way to become my friend? Put me in a situation where I have to stand around and watch everyone else commit murder?
We're talking about a barbecue, not a concentration camp.
Watch it, Councilman.
That wasn't offensive. Shiloh's acting like a burger is the worst crime against humanity.
Making fun of concentration camps is anti-Semitic.
Correct.
Should I say something if I'm a member of Venice Jewish Society?
Oh, sweet baby dreidels.
Perfect segue out of this impossible. Duke, part of Tony's culture involves non-vegan foods. Challah bread, latkes, linses.
If I may interject for a moment. Latkes are vegan, and the other two can be made to be so. I happened to research recipes this morning because I remember Tony was Jewish from a presentation he gave in U.S. history.
Yeah, you remember that?
Of course, it was very interesting. The photos of the diseased, harmless people stacked on top of each other reminded me of the way chickens are shoved thousands into a coop.
Miss Locke.
You can't compare Tony's grandmother to a chicken. One is an animal, one is human.
You're right. One is the greediest, most destructive species on the planet, and the other is a harmless, friendly bird.
My Bubby was super nice.
But Hitler wasn't.
You're not even making sense.
I find it perplexing that people will do anything to protect humans, who can be and often are evil, and at the same time scoff at the protection of animals. And by the way, even Hitler was a vegetarian.
Well, if Hitler did, this changes everything. What a trendsetter!
Animals aren't innocent. Most of them eat meat just like us. Does that make them immoral?
The difference is we don't have to.
I wasn't trying to argue with you, Shiloh. I was merely trying to steer the conversation away from you comparing Tony's relatives to poultry.
Dude, tell us you can't say a barbecue is the Holocaust. One is obviously worse.
You're right. The Holocaust is over. But we continue to celebrate mass murder on grills!
Order, everyone! The Hala is neither here nor there. If Eco Club made back sufficient profit to share return with Miss Locke, why are we here?
I like walking to school to save on gas.
What?
But there was
what?
Storm. Yeah.
Our fourth piece of evidence, provided by Meteorology Club.
Let the record show, Evidence D is a weather report for Monday. Indeed, there were extreme thunderstorms all morning.
Yeah, so I'm on my way to school with all my stuff and a pouch thing for the money for Shiloh, and then boom, storm. So I start running. One, because I have to be in the library by 9, but also, because I'm been precipitated on. So I get halfway there and I realize the bag is open. It's a hand-me-down, because consumerism. So the zipper isn't awesome, and while I was running, the pouch must have fallen out. So I retrace my steps and find the pouch next to a gutter. Open. Empty. $500 washed away. Dude. What a mess I'm in. With that much cash, I could have saved the river dolphin. The $500 down the gutter. Dude, what a careless sin. That money swims free in the water, like an unrescued dolphin. But we have so much money, so I ran to school, got to the library, soaking wet, dripping all over the Black History Appreciation display, and met Shiloh. The Pegwig janitor was watching the whole thing. He really lame.
You absolutely can't call Miss Brandon Muffin lame. She really is lame.
Dude, what?
And you'd better write an apology to the Black Student Union.
It was an accident, dude. Besides, I couldn't focus on that because no matter how I pleaded, Shiloh refused to accept my loan late. I even said I'd pay extra fee. Eco Club is good for it. Have mercy on me, too. There's gotta be a way we can both win. I feel caught in debt, like an endangered dolphin.
A deal's a deal.
There you have it, Student Council. We tried to use logic, but she doesn't care to comply. Why should this man suffer for no other logical reason than Miss Locke's sick pleasure?
I won't accept the money late because that's not what we agreed on. If I had wanted a late fee, I would have asked for a late fee when the very club who finds joy in harassing me asked me for help.
Harassment is a strong word, Miss Locke.
It is. I wouldn't use it if I didn't feel it necessary. I don't care to air my dirty laundry in front of others, so I won't be bringing up past tangential, at best, experiences with Eco Club.
We're trying to make this easy for everyone.
I don't see what is so difficult about enforcing a contract both parties agreed on.
As I already explained, Tony is Jewish. Maybe he doesn't want your weird vegan version of baklava.
And baklava's not Jewish, dude.
Furthering my point, son.
Tony's grandmother would not have cared if you made challah with or without hen periods.
Huh?
Eggs. They're hen periods. You know, a period, a woman's monthly menstruation.
Eggs are hen periods?
What did you think it was?
A baby chick, dude.
So in this scenario, you'd prefer to eat a fetus instead of a period.
Are those my only options?
You can always become a vegan.
As Tony's representation, I strongly urge the president to null the contract and he will pay Shiloh her $500 in full.
Order, order. All right. The defense's case has been presented. I will ask one more time. Miss Locke, will you not agree to the defense's pleas for the contract to be annulled?
No, Your Honor.
You do realize you will not get your $500 back.
Yes, sir.
President, may I say a word?
Of course.
I am very sympathetic to Shiloh's case. I see her points. I am, myself, a vegetarian.
They're not the same.
I recognize that, but we have similar values. I had to ask myself why someone who cares so passionately about her club would deny money that could go toward the cause of progression. I wonder where her true compassions lie if she doesn't want support for what she claims to care about.
I do want support. I want Tony to be a vegan.
I certainly sympathize with the prosecution. Sometimes I feel frustrated as a vegetarian. I can usually only order one or two menu options at restaurants.
Try finding nothing on menus. I can't eat anything in the cafeteria besides potato chips and apples. They even sprinkle Parmesan on the vegetables. Try never eating cake at parties.
You're at parties?
Of course, it is more difficult to be a vegan. I understand you want a friend to do it with you.
I don't care about friends.
Yeah, parties.
Councilman?
The higher number of vegans who exist, the more power we have as a cause. One vegan's life has a much greater impact than $500 ever could. One vegan means a conversation at the dinner table. One vegan creates more publicity than an ad on cable. It's priceless. One person is priceless. One vegan means spreading our message in society. One vegan means spreading knowledge in 3D.
That's priceless. Your excuse is priceless. One more vegan means sharing all the facts you know. One more vegan means you're not going alone.
That's priceless. Your accusation is priceless.
I only want to understand why you refuse a helping hand.
And what you can't seem to see is that people are worth more than money. Tony can stand for so much more if he stuck to this diet. The least we could all do is just simply try it.
I am trying with you, Shiloh, but I'm at my wit's end. How can I explain? You can't make contracts just to have friends. You're
priceless.
If there's one thing we can agree on, it's how much vegans like to talk about themselves.
You're making me talk about myself.
Duke, she's all over the place when this was supposed to be about a contract.
That's what I've been saying this whole time. It's you who keeps getting off base. The contract is clear.
The only thing that's clear is how obnoxious you're being.
Objection!
Councilman, keep in mind.
No more questions.
Miss Locke, do you have any questions for Treasurer Chop?
I do. Mr. Chop, what did you have for lunch yesterday?
Objection, this is irrelevant.
Councilwoman Portia, I have come to realize any questions about food have relevancy today.
Okay, I ate Merchant's Deli, 2 blocks from school.
What did you eat?
I don't remember.
You are under oath, Mr. Chop. I have the receipt.
Ham sandwich.
Two.
I know, it's not kosher.
Evidence E.
It's a receipt from Merchant's Deli for a ham sandwich and two large chocolate chip cookies.
Where did you get that?
The trash.
She dives in the trash cans, folks.
90% of the meat you eat has fecal matter in it.
Why would you mention fecal matter? Because I keep smelling BS.
So, you don't keep kosher.
Bobby would be so disappointed. I never got the point, though.
I don't want you to feel bad. I brought you something. Evidence F.
Evidence F appears to be a ham sandwich.
Here you go, Tony.
Dude, I can't do that now. Not in front of everyone.
Don't you have seventh period, Jim? I heard you did sprints today. And with this meeting after school, I'm sure you didn't have time to pack up a snack. It's okay, Tony. How is it?
You know how it is.
Would you tell the court?
It's delicious.
It's tofu. It's tofu that has been flavored to taste like ham. Same amount of protein, great taste, and completely vegan. Completely kosher.
Duke, I've got homework. This little advertisement is eating into my study time.
Baxter, I too thought this meeting would only last 5 minutes because there was little confusion about a contract, but apparently it was important we discuss Mr. Chop's other beliefs.
It's like, whoa. She thinks she's simmering now. The bubble's starting to pop. But now I've got a surprise. Gonna make her drop.
Jessica?
Hey, babe.
If someone from Harassment Club were here, you'd be skating on thin ice, Mr. Chop. We're already in enough trouble because I'm the current president. Institutionalized privilege structures and all that.
She's my girlfriend, dude.
Sorry I'm late. Someone backed up into a trash can in the senior parking lot. I was cleaning it up.
I hope you checked to make sure Shiloh wasn't inside the garbage.
What are you doing here?
Oh, what's she gonna do?
Jess is our newly appointed secretary.
Haven't you heard? She's bubbling over the pond.
Miss Locke, do you care to continue questioning?
My biggest question is, why are we still here?
Oh, we're cooking now.
I have a contract. And where's Doc New Year?
I'm sorry, our search for justice is putting you out.
You wouldn't know justice if it bit you in the face. But more appropriately, if you were biting into its flesh.
It's good, huh?
Miss Locke, what has gotten into you?
This is a waste of time, President Duke. We can't do anything without Doc New Year. This is just an excuse to bash me as usual.
It was you bashing Councilman Baxter, if I remember correctly. Another outburst like that, and I don't care if Doc New Year isn't here. I'll end the case in Eco Club's favor faster than Kale and a lender.
No further questions.
Am I, good?
You may be reprieved from the stand. In fact, we could all use a break. 5 minutes recess for the court.
What do you want?
Please don't be mad at me.
If that's your condition, I can't talk to you.
Fine, then be mad, but listen to me.
What do you want?
I'm sorry if you feel like I'm wrong.
Was that supposed to be an apology? I'm sorry that you...
That was not an apology. I don't have anything to apologize for.
What do you want?
I understand that you're mad at me. I understand, but I don't agree.
Then you're a hypocrite.
This is what I wanted to talk to you about. People don't like to be called hypocrites.
It's not personal. It's fact. Being a hypocrite is factual. Like having blue eyes or blonde hair. If you're a hypocrite, you're a hypocrite.
Maybe that's true. But calling people hypocrites is not the easiest way to get them on your side.
I don't have a side. It's not my side. It's fact. There aren't sides in fact. In fact, they're history. They're hypocrites.
There are sides today, Shy. People take things personally.
They should learn not to. I don't take it personally that you left me for a boy.
It wasn't just Tony. I like Eco Club.
And you used to like me.
It wasn't personal.
Exactly. It's not personal. You're just wrong.
I'm not.
Show me the evidence that you're right.
Never mind.
You stopped being a vegan. I have evidence that your diet is ethically wrong. You are wrong. It doesn't make much clearer sense than that. And for some dummy!
I like Eco Club.
I'm sure you do. But it's a hypocritical organization that you are now part of, thus making you wrong.
Look, I'm still a vegan.
Then why
let's not bring up the past? Be be mad, but think about showing some mercy. Not just for them, but for you too. It'll benefit you both. People aren't perfect or like people make mistakes or like people screw up. Isn't there some mercy in you? You are not perfect or like people.
Voted second place is still
well, only two people ran.
Well, we wish Susan a very speedy recovery, care and rehab club. And now let us welcome to the stand Eco Club Secretary Jessica Foer.
I don't have anything to do with this.
My documents say you were a member of Vegan Club for 2 years. Is this correct?
Yes, but...
Until your fall of junior year, when you removed yourself from the rosters of Vegans of Venice and joined Eco Club. Is this not also correct?
Yes.
As the only student at Venice High who has been a member of both organizations, your general input would be valuable in this case.
I'm just here to observe.
There are no observers in complex matters. It was the great Black Panther Eldridge Cleaver who once said, if you are not a part of the solution, you are part of the pra.
What was that? My voice recording didn't pick up my microphone.
You are part of the pra. I'm not sure what the last word is supposed to be because that section of the display was wet.
How? You're referencing when Mr. Chop literally rained on the Black Student Union's parade. Part of the pra.
Part of the problem. Part of the problem? You are part of the problem?
Look, I'm doing the best I can.
The end of the quote. I can be part of the solution from over here. Who volunteered me for this?
I'm sorry, Jessica. We didn't know you'd be so uncomfortable.
Well, I am. I'm all in you a few questions.
Can we just get this over with?
Just do it, Jessica. You can't change the contract, and that's all that matters.
Ms. Foer, it would be helpful to hear from a neutral party.
So help you understanding Shakespeare for the freshman reader. I do.
Why don't we just take it from two?
Hi, Jessica. Thanks for doing this. Just a few questions. As you already mentioned, you used to be a member of Vegans of Venice, but recently you quit your dietary restrictions and joined Eco Club.
No.
No?
I didn't quit being a vegan, just the club. And I didn't quit for Eco Club. I just happened to join later. Actually, you can be a member of both clubs, but nobody ever has.
Why do you think that is?
I try not to speak for others.
Others? Vegans of Venice has been around for 4 years, and in those 4 years, it's only had 2 members. You being half of them, you have been a very active member of Eco Club since you joined. Jess can play the compost pile clown at this year's carnival.
You are brilliant.
Yes, you're very passionate about sustainability, but you never had an interest in us before this year?
You're under oath, Jess.
I might have, but I was dissuaded from joining.
What do you mean?
It's no surprise Shyla isn't the biggest fan of your club.
Our club.
Then, sure. And she was my best friend. I looked up to her.
What were some things she would tell you?
Is this relevant?
Proceed, Miss Foer.
She told me the people who joined Eco Club were self-righteous and full of themselves.
Sorry. It's true. And you liked the vegan club?
Yes.
But you quit.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
I got tired.
Go on.
Shiloh has a lot of good ideas. A lot of right ideas. But everything felt so sad. I was always thinking about how wrong everyone was. And then Tony.
Tony?
My boyfriend, Tony. When we started dating, Shiloh didn't exactly approve.
Why is that?
She couldn't understand how I could be with someone who wasn't a vegan.
So you left?
No. I stayed for a while. I explained to her about Tony's good heart and how we all have our faults. I'd rather be happy than not.
But you did leave. Why?
I don't think this is relevant.
You can't hurt my feelings with the truth, Jessica.
She said something that scared me.
What did she say?
You have to remember, last year Shiloh's locker got broken into. It was filled with cheese, the kind in a spray bottle. It doesn't sound so bad, but it happened over the weekend. All her stuff smelled rancid by Monday. Some books were ruined, and the smell never really came out.
Cheeky Shiloh.
People were really mean about it. She had a guess about who did it. Principal Hershey investigated and said the results were inconclusive. But she wanted revenge.
Tell us what she said. What scared you?
It's not important.
The stove is on fire. You were plotting revenge on me?
Everyone knows it was you.
From the pen to the coil. Duke, I was already tried for this crime and found innocent. I will not be attacked anymore.
I had pictures of my family in my locker that were ruined.
Helen is gonna fly off.
Jessica, what did she say she was going to do?
I said if I did to your dog what factories do to pigs, you wouldn't be laughing.
We've reached a boil.
You were going to kill Max's dog?
Cinnamon?
She was really upset, and she didn't mean it. Everyone knows you keep Cinnamon outside at night.
You psycho! Cinnamon's the sweetest pug in the world!
Is everyone hearing this? I've been talking about murder all day. Is everyone hearing this? And you all acted like it was okay. I can't believe this. You say I'm annoying, but now you can't believe this? Like a dog feels more than a cow?
It's man's best friend you're talking about. Or woman's best friend. Man or woman's best friend. And transgender best friend.
Did teachers ever smell things different? Every single flake. We're all perfect and special and equal. Unless you could be a snake. At least your dog would have had a happy little life before I ripped out his paws and sliced his nose off with a knife!
You're a monster!
You're a hypocrite! You've killed hundreds of animals!
But those weren't my dog!
I'm only describing what pigs in factories endure. They're stuffed with drugs and hacked apart in grades of manure!
Shiloh, you need to stop!
We're all about equality here! Can't hurt people's feelings. But everything I've said is fact, and denial is how you're dealing.
It's like you're saying eating hamburgers makes me a murderer.
How hard is it to understand that you can prevent death? How hard is that? It teaches every snowflake's different. What a dirty lie. Because you're not perfect or special or equal if you're born in a pigsty. No one should lose their snowflake. I shouldn't have to say it twice. None of us should lose anyone. Be we humans, pigs, or mice! Even mice!
What are you doing with Snowflake?
What's going on?
She stole Snowflake out of the biology room. It's the lab mouse to take care of.
Took care of you, mean?
Don't!
Things are gonna get better, Shy. I know you miss your mom right now, but—
Give me Snowflake!
This won't make them change! They have to see! They have to see what they do!
I see.
I order you to stop this, Shiloh. No murder in my courtroom.
There's been murder in here since Councilman Dirtface brought up barbecues! You want equality? I'll give you equality. I can only kill this one mouse. I can't go back in time and make it suffer. Only you can do that by keeping the meat industry alive. Think of what your mom would say. She'd tell me to stand up for what's right. Wait!
Everyone needs mercy.
The rat lives.
I stand by my contract. I have nothing else to say.
That is fine, Miss Miller.
Hi, everyone. Apologies for my tardiness. The school board is really great. My cheese, you know? I'm here now. What are we meeting about? Did we finish making the decorations for prom?
Yes. We decided on the theme, Love on the Water.
Sounds good. I'll sign off.
There is this other issue we have on the table today. There was this contract and...
Wait and see. Judgment free.
Does the Eagle Club have the money to repay it?
Yes, but...
How long have you been meeting about this? We're not going to honor a makeshift vegan contract. You know how many phone calls I get about this? Pay the girl back, case closed.
We hadn't picked the prom colors yet.
Love on the Water? Silver and navy.
You heard the lady.
This isn't happening.
Yeehaw, I knew it. Tony, I knew it. I brought something for you to celebrate. Should we write the check now or after Tony eats his first hamburger of freedom?
This is not happening.
I'm afraid it is. What Doc New Year says goes.
Not so fast, everyone. I'm sorry, Link. Could you scroll back to the transcription, say about 15 minutes ago?
What are you looking for?
We're on record. Shiloh said she didn't want the money.
It would be assumed the new outcome.
We gave her the option to take a bargain, and she refused. It's on record. Portia, I don't mean to be rude or anything, but after what we've heard today, I'm not sure I am willing to give any money to someone with an intent to harm, like Shiloh Long.
I will fight this.
It's not personal, Shiloh. I have nothing against you. I was out with my friends, but I just can't trust you. We can't trust
Tony,
you.
Tony, do something.
She was gonna hurt Snowflake.
I'm just like you all. You took my friend, my dignity, and now you want my money too? I'm a vegan, but I'm still human. If you cut me, do I not bleed?
Prosecution seems to be getting upset. Might we take a break, Duke?
2 minutes.
Why are you doing this? I wouldn't really hurt his dog. I said that when I was angry. I was proving a point with Snowflake.
I know.
Then why?
You're smart, Shiloh. But you're too honest. People don't like honesty. Why do you think we can't talk about anything anymore? We don't want the truth.
You
You have reasons to avoid it. Like you're actually going to do something worthwhile with that money.
I'm starting an Eco Club scholarship for the member with the highest GPA. Whatever we get from you will be the prize.
So someone's going to get all my money for themselves.
You? I haven't checked who has the highest grades.
Everybody knows you have the highest grades in the class.
Maybe you're a better person than me. Is that what you want to hear?
Yes.
But it's too easy to push your buttons. You become a grade A brat. Maybe we only ask people to do half as much as you. But at least they do it.
Don't patronize me.
I'm trying to help you. I meant what I said. When we first started high school, I thought we'd be friends.
You wished me a happy birthday last month.
Yeah.
No one else wished me a happy birthday.
Exactly. You just let me be friends with
How did you know it was my birthday?
I'm sorry I wished you a happy birthday. Is that supporting the meat industry too?
You're the front office assistant. Is that how you knew?
Exactly. No deal.
It was you. That's how you got into my locker. Everyone's combo is on file in the front office.
You are not serious.
Now I remember. First semester report cards had just come out. I was number one in the class. You couldn't take being number two.
No one will believe you. You have nothing to go on. You'll just look bitter. I've got $1,000 in your money.
$1,000?
Half a thousand.
Do you have the other 500?
It was lost in the gutter. You heard the story. Tony lost it. Assuming the pouch was full in the first place.
You framed him.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I bet you're not even a vegetarian.
You're messed up, Shyla. People try to give you the benefit of the doubt. You are really sick. Shyla explodes with anger, tackling Portia.
I'm not gonna kill a dog. I'm gonna kill you! Shyla, stop! Portia!
What did you do to her?
What did I do to her? She attacked me! You saw it!
Jess, you have to believe
Jess, me. Come on!
I don't know! Dude, she's a thief!
You refuse to bargain fair and square, Miss Love.
If you ever touch my girl!
Stop! Patrick, Shyla!
Everyone! I think this has been a really hard day for Shyla. I didn't want to say this before, but, well, I read an article in health class. If we don't get enough protein, not only are our bodies weaker, our minds are.
What are you talking about?
If we don't nourish ourselves correctly, the brain can, well, malfunction.
Where did you read that?
I don't remember, but do we need much more evidence?
I'm not crazy. You're evil!
Now, I definitely don't think we should be giving her more money. Who knows how she'll use it?
Doc New Year
yes,
said.
Doc New Year didn't just get strangled! Wait, recently, I got it all. Shyla, you threatened to kill me. That's grounds for expulsion. Look, everyone, look what has become of us. Yes, Shyla attacked me and threatened my life. But I don't blame her. I blame us. Look what we've done today. We pushed her and pushed her and pushed her. We should have accepted her. History has shown us time and time again that progress doesn't happen when we fight. It happens when we get on the same team.
Shame on us.
Shyla, we would be honored if you joined Eco Club.
Are you out of your mind?
I want us to get along. Look, if you join Eco Club, I won't go to Principal Hershey. You won't be expelled. We could make a person stay. Right, Duke?
Well, of course, we just need a signed document from both presidents to collapse clubs. Link draft the papers, would you?
It's already done.
She said things. Terrible things to me.
I think we all said some things we're not proud of today.
Shyla, it'd be dope if you joined our club.
Of course, by merging clubs, you merge your funds as well.
You have another $1,000 in your club savings from the past 4 years, don't you?
My sister's starting high school next year. She's a vegan too, and I thought that-
Join the club or get expelled. Seems pretty obvious.
All we need are your signatures.
You already signed. You ready to sign, Shyla?
Ladies and gentlemen of Student Council, this is what compromise looks like. Now, Shyla, we're so happy you joined our club, but you've proven today you can be unstable. Before you walk home, for our sake, have some protein. Don't be cold, Portia. Shyla is our friend. We have to take care of her.
It's true what they say. High schoolers are so mean.
High schoolers aren't mean. People are. After high school, we just learn to hide better. So, hungry?
Lights fade to black.
bend this way. Not tomorrow and not today. We don't have to live this way. So you could be right, but if no one's on your side, you might think.
Everyone needs mercy.